I'm going to find out how the cocoa bean gets transformed into chocolate. I'm going behind the scenes with master chocolate makers, Sepp Schong-Backler and Lionel Tisser.
Wow, so this is where all the beans come in.
For over 100 years here, up to 35 varieties of cocoa beans from around the globe have been turned into high-end chocolate, used in professional kitchens the world over.
So where did the best cocoa beans come from?
You walk just to the right bean. So this is Maracaibo Grand Cru.
So this is like the Aston Martin.
It's very important to understand as well that the farmer that we are working with, they are not using artificial chemical product for the fertilizing.
Right, so all organic.
All organic.
Yeah.
So this is now a dried bean.
But I mean, part of the health benefits of chocolate is the fact that it's a bean, right?
Yeah.
And pretty much beans are always incredible for health.
The beans have to be cleaned and sterilized by steaming them at 170 degrees Celsius. Once they're roasted and cooled, the cocoa beans are cracked to reveal their precious cargo, the cocoa nib.
So that's the cocoa nib?
Yeah, that's the cocoa nib.
So that's what it's all about.
It's the cocoa nib that gets transformed into chocolate as we know it. First, it's liquefied.
Wow, it smells incredible!
This is a first for me, an intoxicating taste of 100% pure cocoa liquor.
It's delicious, but it's quite dry. I mean, it's
dry.
That is pure chocolate.
This is pure, and you will see this will stay 25 to 30 minutes in your mouth. The flavor will change.
Oh, my Lord.
This is where it starts to take shape. The liquor is mixed with liquid cocoa butter, granulated sugar, and if the recipe calls for it, Madagascan vanilla. It eventually ends up here in these conching machines from the 1930s. They constantly move to aerate the mixture and develop the flavor and texture. This can take up to 72 hours.
Oh, it's heavy. Oh, look at that.
I always compare this with good winemaking in a barrel, because you develop the flavor very slowly over time.
What eventually comes out is high-quality chocolate known as couverture, ready to be shipped out to chocolatiers to make into confectionery all over the world.
So this is the bit I'm waiting for, boys.
That's it.
All of that love and that care. So that was one of the most delicious chocolates I've ever put in my mouth. I mean, this is probably the most unusual moment for me in the wonderful world of superfood, because obviously chocolate has sugar in it, and sugar is a problem in our diets. We're having too much of it. But at the same time, the cocoa bean has got incredible nutritional kind of caliber, hasn't it?
That's right.
Your average bar of chocolate is often low in the good stuff and high in sugar. To get the best from chocolate, get the dark stuff with high cocoa content.
So if you're in the shops, you should go for, like, what, 60% cocoa solids? Yes. 70%
yes.
cocoa solids?
Sure, yeah.
You'll have a better product, you'll enjoy it more, and it'll have way less sugar. Chocolate is one of the nicest things in life. And if you're going to have it, do it right.